भागवतम कैंटो 1 चैप्टर 5 नारदास इंस्ट्रक्शंस ऑन श्रीमद् भागवतम फॉर व्यास देवा श्लोक 22 इदम हि पुंसः तपसः श्रुतस्य वा स्विष्टस्य सुक्तस्य च बुद्धिदत्तयोः अविच्य युतो अर्थः कविभि निरूपितो यद् उत्तम श्लोक गुणानो वर्णम ट्रांसलेशन लर्न सर्कस हैव पॉजिटिवली कंक्लूडेड दैट द इनफैलिएबल पर्पस ऑफ द एडवांसमेंट ऑफ नॉलेज नेमली ऑस्टेरिटी स्टडी ऑफ द वेदास सैक्रिफाइस चैंटिंग ऑफ हेमंस एंड चैरिटी कल्मिनेट्स इन द ट्रांसडेंटल डिस्क्रिप्शंस ऑफ द लॉर्ड हु इज डिफाइंड इन चॉइस पोएट्री Purport. Human intellect is developed for advancement of learning in art, science, philosophy, physics, chemistry, psychology, economics, politics, etc. By culture of such knowledge, the human society can attain perfection of life. This perfection of life culminates in the realization of the Supreme Being, Vishnu. The Shruti therefore directs that those who are actually advanced in learning should aspire for the service of Lord Vishnu. Unfortunately, persons who are enamored by the external beauty of Vishnu Maya do not understand that culmination of perfection or self-realization depends on Vishnu. Vishnu Maya means sense enjoyment, which is transient and miserable. Those who are entrapped by Vishnu Maya utilize advancement of knowledge for sense enjoyment. Shri Narad Muni has explained that all paraphernalia of the cosmic universe is but an emanation from the Lord out of His different energies, because the Lord has set in motion by His inconceivable energy actions and reactions of the created manifestation. They have come to be out of His energy, they rest on His energy, and after annihilation they merge into Him. Nothing is therefore different from Him, but at the same time the Lord is always different from them. When advancement of knowledge is applied in the service of Lord, the whole process becomes absolute. The personality of Godhead, His transcendental name, fame, glory, etc., are all non-different from Him. Therefore, all the sages and devotees of the Lord have recommended that the subject matter of art, science, philosophy, physics, chemistry, psychology, and all other branches of knowledge should be wholly and solely applied in the service of the Lord. Art, literature, poetry, painting, etc. may be used in glorifying the Lord. The fiction writers, poets, and celebrated literatures are generally engaged in writing of sensuous subjects. But if they turn towards the service of the Lord, they can describe the transcendental pastimes of the Lord. Valmiki was a great poet, and similarly Vyasadeva is a great writer, and both of them have absolutely engaged themselves in delineating the transcendental activities of the Lord, and by doing so they have become immortal. Similarly, science and philosophy also should be applied in the service of the Lord. There is no use presenting dry speculative theories for sense gratification. Philosophy and science should be engaged to establish the glory of the Lord. Advanced people are eager to understand the absolute truth through the medium of science, and therefore a great scientist should endeavor to prove the existence of the Lord on a scientific basis. Similarly, philosophical speculation should be utilized to establish the supreme truth as sentient and all-powerful. Similarly, all other branches of knowledge should always be engaged in the service of the Lord. In the Bhagavad Gita also the same is affirmed. All knowledge not engaged in the service of the Lord is but nascence. Real utilization of advanced knowledge is to establish the glories of the Lord and that is the real import. Scientific knowledge engaged in the service of the Lord and all similar activities are all factually Hari Kirtan or glorification of the Lord.